Good evening, everyone. In an attempt to make space for everyone that is involved in the concert, if we could please fill in any gaps that are available in the seats. Thank you very much.
Good evening, folks. If you haven't had a chance to, as you came in the auditorium, there are white sheets of paper that are hanging on the wall. There are two QR codes that are there. One is for the program for tonight's show. So if you have a phone and you want to download using the QR code, you have the program there. Also, there's one for our capital project survey. We are in the project, not capital project, but 5-year strategic plan. Our 5-year strategic plan is going to be ending this coming June, and we need your input to build the next one. So far, we've had over 400 people fill it out, which is awesome, and we want to get that number even higher. So if you have an opportunity, you've got some time to kill here before the concert starts in about 10 minutes. So again, the program and the strategic plan survey is there for your interest. Thank you so much. We'll get started in a few minutes. Good evening once again, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Homer High School and this year's installment of our all-district instrumental concert. The kids are very excited. I just was in the band room, and they're all ready and raring to get in here and show you their stuff, which is quite impressive. A couple things that we always want to go through before we start a concert. That is, if we need to leave it quickly, please do so as carefully as you can. If you're seated in the middle to the back of the auditorium, if you could leave through the doors nearest the lobby that you came in, that would be wonderful. If you're sitting down in the front half, if you could go out these doors to either side, that would be just fantastic. We have planned no power outage for tonight, as we experienced last week, so we should be all set. A couple of other things. I did mention earlier that there are some QR codes posted around the auditorium. One has the program for tonight's concert. The other is a survey that we'd like to help you, have you help us out with to fill it out so that we can get some feedback as it relates to how we want Homer Schools to look for the next 5 years, starting July 1st, 2024. I'm going to be sending another communication out about that tomorrow through Parent Square. So if you want to wait, if you haven't had a chance to do it yet and you want to do it then, we would be very appreciative of that. So as you can see, there's activity behind me. This is the highlight of the evening, the kids performing. So I'll turn it over to Mrs. Madison and the fourth grade beginning band. So once again, welcome and enjoy tonight's all district instrumental concert.
As we're getting a little bit adjusted to this stage, so we're adding some chairs, I have some thank yous that I need. So this is this year's beginning band, fourth grade beginning band. We started the school year this year not knowing how to play a single note, not knowing how to open our case, and we started with one note, and we added another note, and so forth, and it's been a lot of work. It's been a lot of duct tape. And here we are. We finally made it here. Some other people that I need to thank. The reason that this job is made a little bit easier is because of people like Mrs. Combs and Miss Nisted, who give them such a wonderful foundation that they already know how to read notes. And we do a lot of counting and clapping, and then we bring that same counting and clapping to beginning band two lessons. So you're going to see the kids bopping and moving their instruments and so forth, because that's how we do some of the counting, and that's how they do counting in music class, and then we bring it right into fourth grade. Back there, I do have some heroes that are here to help me. Mrs. Combs is back there, getting that row adjusted, and Mrs. Voorhees is back there, and she comes to all of my fourth grade rehearsals and helps us to keep the percussion section in line, because every one of those kids has different music. Every single one of them has different music that they're playing individually. So thank you to them very much. And Mrs. Ostrander is here helping me with all of the kiddos too, because there's a lot of kids between fourth, fifth, and sixth grade. So here we go, this year's beginning band. We're gonna start with our scale to warm up. That's a pretty big deal. So we're gonna warm up with our scale, and then we're gonna do power rock, okay? All right, and at the very end, afterwards, I'm gonna have them stand row by row so that you can see them and you can get pictures then. After the concert is completed, you can meet your child in the band room, but that's the same room where you drop them off. You can meet them in the band room, and that's for grades 4, 5, and 6. Thank you.
Thank you. Hello, it's so great to see all of you here tonight. Such a big crowd for this awesome night here of music. We have here our 5th and 6th grade advanced band. This is a really cool band where Miss Madison and I both get to teach together and kind of bridge that gap, which has been really nice and is a nice way to learn some of these kids and get to know them before they come up into the junior high. We're going to start here with our first song called River City Parade. Thank you. This is a really fun group to work with. They're really excited. They do a really great job. And that was a really challenging piece for us. It has a lot of different parts, even within saxophones, clarinets, trumpets, all those. They're all playing different parts from each other. There are at least two different parts. So this was kind of a first step into what you're going to see more in the 7th and 8th grade band, where a lot of students are on their own parts. And they did a really great job with it. I'm going to hand you over next to Miss Madison for our next song.
All right, the next piece that we're going to do is called Mechanical Monsters. This was one that I heard some recordings of, and I thought, you know, we need to do this piece. And it's pretty interesting. So if you could imagine a giant mechanical monster, and occasionally a hose comes loose, and you're going to hear shh and all kinds of different sounds, and you're going to hear some tapping and different things. So imagine in your head that we have a big giant machine, a big robot up here. So Mechanical Monsters.
Next up, we have here the 7th and 8th grade junior high band. They are also a really fun group to work with, and they have come a long ways musically. I'm really excited about these two pieces that we have for you, too. They've really been selling these two. We do have a couple of sick people out that we're missing today, so I want to give a shout out to Drew and Zen, our high schoolers, who allowed us to adopt them for this, so thank you. This first piece that we're going to start with is called A Holst Hymn. It's based off of the music from Gustav Holst's The Planets. It's from Jupiter, but it's also used in all sorts of things. It's a melody called Thaxton, I Vow to Thee, My Country. It's used in all sorts of, like, royal family things. There are several settings that are specific hymns with different words as well. There's even an episode of Bluey with this melody in there. Just, it's everywhere. So you might recognize this melody, even if you don't know this, because there are so many settings of it. It's just a really beautiful, simple kind of melody that they've come really far musically on, and I hope you enjoy this. I'm really proud of them for that one. Playing a slow piece is by no means easier. It's really, really difficult to do that, and they did a great job and came a long ways on that. Our next song here, I think you're really going to enjoy. I think a lot of people on stage here have. This is called High Watermark, the Third Day. And this is really a programmatic piece that's retelling the third day in Gettysburg and kind of the turning point of the Civil War. So you're going to hear troops battling it out in the trumpets and the snare drums, some cannon shots, some fifes, all sorts of things going on. And there's really a range of emotions from the quiet church bells in the beginning before battle begins in the day to being in a full-on battle and then eventually kind of mourning everybody that was lost in that day. They've done a really good job with this piece, and I think you'll enjoy it here today. Thank you.
Thank you. Good evening. Wow, that was pretty hot. How you guys doing? So, yeah, we have a little bit of a setup issue going on. We will just be just a more one more moment, and we will get going here. So our first piece is called Up and Up. It's a Latin jazz piece. We're going to have a couple soloists in here. The jazz band rehearses just once per week, so I'm going to be saying this for your benefit as much as the kids behind me. So we have four improv soloists. That means they're going to be making up music on the fly. They won't be using music. They will be just making it up spontaneously. And we have solos first by Amelia, Orion, and then in our sax section, we have Hannah and then Nick. So those are our improv solos for tonight. Thank you. you, Amelia, Orion, Hannah, and Nick on those solos. So our last piece for the evening is called Buck Jump. It is a piece written and performed by a really great trombone player called Trombone Shorty. Maybe if you go to the Jazz Fest regularly in Syracuse, he was performing there a few years ago. And he's a New Orleans player that has just a lot of great, youthfulness to him, and this piece is no exception. And we will have some other improv solos now. I will just announce it now in case I forget. So we are starting with Nick this time. Right? Wow, okay. Starting with Nick again on sax. Of course, I left my glasses in the band room, as you can tell. Maddie and then Emma on piano. And Lauren is going to do a Barry sax solo for us over there. And who is that? Oh, then trombones. We have Ryan and Sean on trombone. So I think you'll like this. This is called Buck Jump by Trombone Shorty. Thank you. So if you haven't figured out already, our next piece is going to feature the saxophone section, all 3,000 of them. Now, a lot of these saxophone players you're going to see in just a minute, they're going to put down their saxophones and pick up clarinets and flutes and oboes and bassoons and everything else. So it's really amazing how many kids are taking up not only their own instrument, but other instruments too, and playing them both very proficiently. So this piece is written by Billy Joel. It's a little-known tune, but a really great tune. It's called Root Beer Rag, and will feature our saxophone section. I don't know if that's a record or not, but it certainly should be, I think. So while we are finding our spots for our last selection of the night, which will be Wicked, I have a couple thank yous to do. A big thanks to Zach tonight up in the sound and lighting booth. Thank you, Zach. Mr. Dependable. I'd also like to give a big thanks to the administration. Obviously, I think if I ever did anything else, I could probably be like an events coordinator, if anybody needs any weddings organized or anything, I'm here for you. So, because this is a really big thing to put together with all these people here, the parking, everything else. Administration really takes a lot off my plate for that. And even like you notice in the program, you know, I did give a shout out to Todd Lisi. I mean, because this is not in every district the same, that we have such cooperation between all the facets of what we do here. So, you know, Mr. Lisi was nice enough to, you know, not have sports tonight, for example. That doesn't happen in every district. So it really does take a village. So thanks to all our administration, our staff here at Homer High School, and especially the music staff here. I always say this every year, but it's true that I get to take credit for a lot of their hard work. You're seeing sometimes the culmination of 9 years of music study here on the stage tonight. So that's amazing. I'd also like to thank, obviously, you, the parents for, you know, for your support and getting to do what they need to do, permission slips and all that good stuff. And a really big thanks to all the kids that performed tonight. I thought everybody did a really great job, and it's really nice to see the progression from 4 to 12. So our last piece is entitled Selections from Wicked. If you don't know, Wicked is a really, it's about 20 years old now. I think this is the 20th anniversary of Wicked on Broadway. And when it hit, it was kind of a big thing, kind of like Hamilton is now. This band and the high school choir next week will be traveling to New York City to compete against some other bands on the Eastern Seaboard. And while we are in New York City, we're actually going to see the Broadway show Wicked. So it was kind of nice to tie that in with what we're doing next week, too, because a lot of them haven't been to New York, haven't seen the show. So when they go see it, they'll really understand a lot more what's happening, I hope. So I think that's it. So I think I've thanked everybody. I think we're going to finish our evening with selections from Wicked. I should mention, too, I just forgot, before we get started here, if you're a parent chaperoning on that New York City trip, if we could see you for just like 10 minutes afterwards, if you didn't come to the meeting at last week's vocal concert, that would be terrific. Thank you.